हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन आर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2, दैट इज न्यूट्रिशन इन एनिमल्स। सी, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज इंजेशन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, हियर यू हैव टू राइट डेफिनेशन ऑफ इंजेशन, दैट इज द इनटेक ऑफ फूड into the mouth is known as what? Ingestion. See, second, the breaking down of complex food molecules by the action of enzymes is called what? Digestion. Next, parasites do not digest food. True or false? False. Next is what? How do amoeba and hydra get nutrition? For this question you have to write full explanation of the nutrition about amoeba and hydra, that how they get their nutrition. In next part, is there any difference in the way they digest food? Yes, amoeba take its food through intracellular digestion, and whereas in hydra extracellular digestion take place. I repeat, in amoeba intracellular digestion take place, whereas in hydra extracellular digestion takes place. Next we are having what do you understand by vertebrates? We all know vertebrates are higher organisms that have a backbone. See, what is our next question? That pulpy mass of food formed by chewing is called what? Bolus. B-O-L-U-S. Okay. Next is what? Which digestive juices are secreted by liver and pancreas? Liver secretes bile juice and pancreas secrete what? Pancreatic juice. Third, in which organ is food turned into chyme? That is stomach. Next, how many permanent teeth do adults have? Adults have total 32 permanent teeth. See students, our next question is what? Name the chambers of a ruminant stomach. That you can write by yourself, that 4 chambers of a ruminant stomach are this. Next is what? There are only 2 pairs of salivary glands in our mouth? No, there are 3 pairs of salivary glands in our mouth. Next is what? Who are ruminants? So students, ruminant is an animal that digests its food in 2 steps, and ruminants include cattle, goat, sheep, camels. Okay, next we are having what is emulsification of fats? Emulsification of fat means what? The breaking down of the big molecules of fat into smaller ones, that is fat into fatty acids and glycerol. See students, next we are having what? Bookwork. See, first MCQ is what? That in humans most of the digestion and absorption of food is completed where? In small intestine. Second, saliva acts on what? Starch. Incisors help in biting the food. Fourth, elimination of undigested food and waste material from the body is called ingestion. Amoeba ingests food with the help of pseudopodia. Next we are having what? The digestive organs together form the alimentary canal. Fats are broken down by digestive enzymes into fatty acids and glycerol. The buccal cavity comprises teeth, tongue and 3 pairs of salivary glands. See students, next is what? Movement of food through oesophagus is known as what? Peristaltic movement. Next is what? Chemically active substance present in digestive juices, enzymes. Semi-digested food regurgitated by ruminants is what? Curd. Mouth part of butterflies used to suck nectar is what? Proboscis. Next we are having what? That what is assimilation? What do you understand by assimilation? So it is what? The process in which the simple molecules that are absorbed by the body are changed into substances required by the body for various functions, growth and development. Is it essential for all organisms? Yes, because through this process we get energy. In second question, you have to list out the types of teeth present in your mouth, that is incisors, canines. You have to explain all the types of teeth along with their functions. Name any two unicellular and multicellular animals, like unicellular amoeba, paramecium. In multicellular, you can write any hydra, spider, frog, all are what? Multicellular animals. Next, how are canines different from molars? Difference. So you have to write in tabular form, one side canine, one side molars. See, you can write first point as there are in total four canines in our mouth, including lower jaw and upper jaw. Whereas we are having 12 molars, including lower jaw and upper jaw. In second, you can write this way, that canines help in the tearing of food. In molars, you can also write this way, that molars help in the chewing of the food. See, next is where are taste buds located? They are located on our tongue. Next is what differentiate between alimentary canal and digestive system. So here you can write their definitions, that alimentary canal is what? A long tube starting from the mouth and ending at the anus. This digestive tract is known as what? Alimentary canal. Whereas in case of digestive system, what you can write? At the digestive tract, that means the alimentary canal along with the glands form what? Digestive system. Okay. See, next question is what? Describe the various steps involved in heterotrophic mode of nutrition. So first you will make a hint at the various steps involved in heterotrophic mode of nutrition are, then you have to explain all the steps, ingestion, digestion, assimilation, all the five steps you have to explain. In second question, you have to describe the stomach of a ruminant, that we have discussed thoroughly. You will draw the diagram of the stomach of the ruminant, then you will explain all the four parts, all the four chambers of the ruminant. Why are ruminants able to digest cellulose? Because ruminants are having what? Cellulose digesting bacteria in their stomach. Explain the functions of main glands associated with the human digestive gland. Here you have to explain the three glands, liver, pancreas, salivary glands, along with their diagrams. Okay. See students, next we have to discuss hard questions. First is what? The mouth of a human being has two pipe openings, one each for air and food. So why does food enter only the food pipe and not the windpipe? Find out. So the answer will be that in our mouth we are having two pipe openings, one each for air and food. But what happens when we are eating food? A flap like structure, epiglottis, present in our throat closes the stream of the windpipe and the food enters only in the food pipe, not in the windpipe. Next question is what? Did cows and buffaloes are seen chewing even when they are not grazing or eating anything? We know that cow and buffaloes are what? Ruminants. And the ruminants do what? The process of rumination. That means they have to brought back cud from the stomach to the mouth and chewed it again and again. okay. So cow and buffaloes are what? Ruminants, and they have to just do the process of rumination. That means they have to thoroughly chew the cud. Okay, so this is all about our chapter number 2. So you have to write the question answers of this chapter in your fear notebook, and you have to send your homework positively to me. And along with this video, I am sending you a PDF from where you can read the content and frame your answers carefully. Okay, so goodbye, have a nice day.